We're discussing if shechivat achota osarta, if being with the wife's sister is osir the wife. So the Gemara says, why? How come in the Mishnah, when the wife goes away and they tell him that his wife died, and he marries his sister, how come we don't make her asur, make his wife asur on him like we made the wife asur on the husband when she married somebody else, Bishogeg? So the Gemara says, by ishto de bimizid asira, if she has asur midoraita Bishogeg gazru barabanan. So the gozer Bishogeg to consider it like a mizid. Rashi on the bottom, de bimizid mitzira midoraita dechtiv. Vilo nitfasa, she wasn't grabbed. The mashma isura, the mashma asura, hilgach bishogeg, when she did it by accident, kigon al pi bedin gazu barbanan, that she's like a mezid. Ta'apa hot isha, the bemezid lo asira, hot isha, the bemezid, she's not asur, Rashi. Ta'afilu bemezid bala hota lo mitzira ishto ilave, even if he's on purpose with his wife's sister, his wife doesn't become asur on him, iduraita. Kidakatani lekaman, like it says over the hilkach bishogeg, they didn't make a gezira. Hilkach bishogeg lugazu rabanan. Gemara continues, uminalan de lo asira. How do we know that a woman doesn't become asur if the man has relations with her sister? The Tanya, otah shechivata osarta ve'en shechivata achota osarta. Otah Rashi v'shachav ish otah. It's the only time a lady becomes asur, right, is v'shachav ish ota. But if somebody sleeps with somebody else, who you might think makes her asur, it's not osir. Then shechivat achota osarta. Doesn't make a difference. Just like if a man has relationships with an ishet ish, it doesn't make a difference if it's for fun, or he wanted to marry her, or he thought he was the Kohen Gadol, or he wanted to make Mashiach. Either way, she's asur. So too with the sister. It doesn't make a difference what his game plan is. Ve'en shechivat achota osarta. Shiacho v'halodinu. We could have made a kal v'homer. Uma b'makom shebal isur kal. When a man has relations with a lighter isur, and the Gemara is going to define who this lighter isur is. Ne'esar ha'oser, the cause of the isur becomes asur. Makom shebal isur hamur. Enodin sheneesara oser, when he has relations with the isur hamur, certainly the one that causes the isur should become asur. That's the kal v'chomer. So we're gonna explain it now. Let's look in Rashi. V'halodin hu sheteesor ulkach neemarota. Meaning, there's a logic that there's a kal v'chomer that you should say that she is asur, and therefore we need a pasuk to exclude it. I don't need a pasuk to tell me that something is mutar if there's no reason to make it asur, right? You don't have to tell me you're allowed to eat wheat. Unless the Torah tells you wheat, you have to have oranges. Unless there's a reason to assume it should be asur, I don't need a special pasuk to be matir. Right? Makom shebal isur kal. Lekaman, so now already the Gemara is giving you, Rashi is going to give you a, he's going to cheat for you. He's going to let you know the end of the sugya on the bottom of the page. It's not on? What about it? Right? The Rashi is giving you the maskana of the sugya. Lekaman mukim la be'eshet ish. The Gemara is going to say that the isur kal is eshet ish. It's not something that you normally call isur kal. Say, abba le'eshet ish, en lo chelik lo'olam abba. So what are we talking about? Be'eshet ish. Ve'amai kari la isur kal. She'ena osra osra kol yamav. For this point, it's considered kal, because it's not, she's not necessarily asur the whole time that the one who made her asur is alive. For example, if a man marries a woman, right? She's asur on him as long as he stays married. When he divorces her, she becomes mutar. Whereas her sister is asur even after he divorces his wife. So which isur is more hamur? The isur of eshet ish or the Isur of Achot Ishto. Achot Ishto lasts longer than Eshet Ish. So we're going to consider Achot Isha Hamur and Eshet Ish Kal. Right? The one who made her asur is the man. Osra kol yamav. She's not asur forever. Share yesh eter beget. So let's read it inside. Uma valodin. Uma b'makom sheval isur kal. When he has relations with the light isur. Ne'esar ha'oser. Right? The one who made her asur. So a guy has bi'ah with the Eshet Ish, right? Who's the Oser of the, let's say Shimon sleeps with Reuven's wife. Who was the Oser of Reuven's wife? Reuven. So he slept with Reuven's wife. The Oser, Reuven, became Asur. Right? That's by Isur Kal. Isur Hamur. If a guy sleeps with his wife's sister, right? Who's Isur Hamur? Why? Because she's Asur as long as the Oser is alive. The Oser is his wife. As long as his wife is alive, her sister's asur. So it's an isur hamur. So we'll say that if he sleeps with the isur hamur, ne'esar ha'oser. The wife, who's the oser, should be asur on you. En odin she ne'esar ha'oser. Rashi ne'esar ha'oser, ne'esar ba'ala ha'asura la'chinin. That's by Eshet Ish. Makom sheba al isur hamur. Kegon ahot ishto. Like his wife's sister, Shishto Oseret et Achota Kol Yamav. His wife causes her sister to become asur on her husband forever. En odin she ne'esar ha'oser. Certainly, we should be oser, the one that makes her asur. She te'aser ishto, his wife, ha'oseret et Achota, who's causing her sister to be asur. Kach ne'emar ota. That's why it says ota to tell you that the only time somebody becomes asur by a shechiva is eshet ish. Ota shechivata osarta ve'en shechivat ahota. The sleeping with a sister, we might have said, is osir, but kal v'chomer does not osir her. Yes?
And her husband dies. He's not marrying her after?
No.
So it's an isur forever.
Yeah, but it wasn't the isur.
That's a separate isur. We're learning the esara oser. We're just looking at the esara oser.
But the source has nothing to do with the husband.
Not true.
If the husband dies, she's about to.
I'm not looking at when she's asur to the person who slept with her. I'm looking at when the cause of her isur, how long is he asur? The cause of the isur, who made the eshet ish asur? In the world, the husband. When somebody sleeps with her, the oser becomes asur, right?
Yeah.
So too, when somebody sleeps,
it's really not relevant here because it's asur the isur of the guy.
You're not following. The oser of eshet ish is her husband. The oser of a wife's sister is the wife. Just like when somebody sleeps with an eshet ish, somebody that wasn't involved in that dealing, the husband becomes asur. Right? So to over here, if somebody sleeps with his wife's sister, the cause of that isur, which is the wife, should become asur on the man who slept with her.
When you said the husband becomes asur, in terms of what?
Into his wife.
Into his wife.
It's asur to his wife, right? That's the same thing here. The osir becomes asur in her. So to over here, the osir, which is the sister, should become asur to you. Says the Gemara. Amar of Yehuda. Lo nechlaku. Bet Shammai or Bet Hillel. There is no machlok in Bet Shammai and Bet Hillel. Beba al hamoto. If a man has relations with his mother-in-law, sheposel et ishto, that his wife becomes asur on him. Everybody agrees to that. Rashi beba al hamoto sheposel et ishto alav ulkaman yalif la mikra. We're going to learn it from a pasuk. Alma nechlaku. What do they argue about? Beba al achot ishto. Somebody who's with his wife's sister. Shebet Shammai Omrim, Bet Shammai says, Posel, he's Posel his wife. Ubet Hillel Omrim, lo Posel. Bet Hillel says he's not Posel. Rashi. Correct. Shebet Shemai Omrim Posel Mikal Vahomer. Keda Amaran, like we said. Ve'ota lo darshi. They're not Doresh Ota. That's Rabbi Yehuda. So according to Rabbi Yehuda, according to Bet Shammai, another two ways a man can become Asur on his wife, if he sleeps with his mother-in-law or his sister-in-law. He has to divorce his wife. Amar Rabbi Yossi, and Betalel, according to Rabbi Yehuda, holds mother-in-law yes, sister-in-law no. Amar, meaning mother-in-law yes, the wife becomes Asur, sister-in-law, the wife doesn't become Asur. Amar Rabbi Yossi, lo nechlaku bet shamay u bet hillel bebal achot ishto shelo posel et ishto. It's no. By the wife's sister, everybody agrees she's not posel because they learn ota, Rashi. Amar Rabbi Yossi, lo nechlaku shelo posel de dorshin ota. Al ma nechlaku, when do they argue? Bebal hamoto, a man who's with his mother-in-law. Shebet Shammai Omrim Posel. Bet Shammai says, being with the mother-in-law is Posel, the wife. Ubet Hillel Omrim Lo Posel. Bet Hillel says it's not Posel. Rashi, Shebet Shammai Omrim Posel. By the mother-in-law, Tedarchinon Oto Ve'etenke Del Kaman. Lefi Shebet Techila Hayehu Mutar Bekol Anashim Sheba'olam. In the beginning, Rashi, Rabbi Yossi mefaresh ta'amad lo nechlaku al achot isha. Why don't they oser achot isha? Lefi shebetechila hu mutar bekol anashim shebaolam. He's allowed to marry almost every woman in the world. Vehi muteret bekol anashim shebaolam. And she can marry almost every guy in the world. Kedisha, when he marries her, hu osra vehi osarto. He causes isurim on her, and she causes isurim on him.
What happens?
He married her.
No, but what's the isur? What's
this
going to be?
Let's see. Merubeh isur she'asara mi'isur she'asartahu. He made her more asur than she made him. Shehu asara bekol anashim sheba'olam. He made her asur in every man in the world. V'hi lo asartahu ela bekrovoteha. She only osir him in her relatives. So let's make a kal vachomer. Umahu she'asara bekol anashim sheba'olam. He made her asur in all the men in the world. Shagiga, if she made a mistake, be'asur la in one of those men. Ena ne'eseret be'mutar la. She doesn't become asur in the man who she's allowed, meaning if she sleeps with somebody b'shogeg, she's allowed to go back to her husband. She thought it was her husband. She thought her husband was dead. Right? Mahi she'asara b'kol anashim sheba'olam. His asur of her is more hamur. Right? Yeah. If she made a shogeg, she's mutar and her husband. He shelo asartahu ela b'krovoteha. She who's asur of him was only in her relatives. Less. Shagag be'asur lo. If by mistake he slept with her sister, let's say he thought it was her. En odin shelo, or he thought she was dead. En odin shelo ne'esar be'mutar lo. That he doesn't become asur, and the one that's mutar to him is the wife. V'zeh hadin l'shogeg. That's only by shogeg. Rashi, v'zeh hadin l'shogeg. Hadin hazeh melamedenu ala shogeg shelo pisala. L'mezid minayin. How do we know that if he b'mezid slept with her sister that she's not asur? Tamud lomar otah. We have a pasuk otah. V'shachav ish otah. Otah shechivata osarta. V'en shechivata hota osarta. And the shechivah of her sister doesn't make her asur. My ta'amad Rabbi Yehuda. What's Rabbi Yehuda's reason? Rashi, the Amar Abal Hamoto Pasal Et Ishto. I mean, Rabbi Yehuda says everybody agrees the mother-in-law makes the daughter Asur. Dichtiv, it says, Ba'esh Yisrefu Oto Ve'eten. A man who sleeps with his mother-in-law, they should burn him and them. V'chi Kol Abayit Kulo B'Srefa. We're going to burn everybody? What did everybody do? It's only him and the mother-in-law. Emeno inyan l'srefa, if you're not burning his wife because she didn't do anything, tenehu inyan l'isura, say that it applies that once he slept with his mother-in-law, his wife becomes asur on him. Rashi, v'chi kol habayit b'srefa ishto ma'achat asirata. Oh, sorry. Amar v'yuda meshmul. En halacha k'rabi Yehuda. The halacha is not like Rabbi Yehuda, and the man who sleeps with his mother-in-law does not oser his wife on him. Says the Gemara, Hahu de'abad isura b'hamate. A man did an isur by going with his mother-in-law. Atyeh Rav Yehuda, Nagder. Rav Yehuda brought him down, and he gave him malkut. What's that? Oh, Jack, here. Yeah. He gave him malkut. Right? Amar le, he loved the Amar Shmuel en halacha k'Rabbi Yehuda. If not for the fact that Shmuel already said halacha is not like Rabbi Yehuda, asarte alach isura de alam. I would have made your wife asur on you forever. Rashi, asarte alach l'intetach. And the mother-in-law is asur already. Okay. Now the Gemara goes back to analyze that braita. The braita tried to make a kalvahomer to make the mother, the sister, the wife asur from the bi'av, the sister-in-law. My isur kal. What's the isur kal that we say that if he does an isur kal, the oser becomes asur on him? My isur kal. Amar av chizda mahazir girushato mishenised. Let's say it's a mahzir girushato mishenised, a man who returned his girusha. So Reuven was married to Rachel. He divorced her. She married Shimon, right? So when she married Shimon, she became asur on Reuven. Now Reuven takes her back. She becomes asur on Shimon. She's not Ishtish anymore. She's a double X. She's his ex, and she's Shimon's ex. Shimon divorced her. So is Reuven allowed to marry again? No. But if Reuven marries her, guess what? Now she becomes asur on Shimon. Because if Shimon marries her, he's mahzik irushato mishenised. Right? Yes. Kedushin is tovsin b'chai ve'lavin. Right? Let's see. No, because I want to say isur kal. He's asur. Somebody else is not asur. You're not talking isur kal. Over here it's isur kal. Right? Machzik yirushato mishenised. Ba'aleha hai. Asara ale dehai. When Reuven sleeps with her again, she becomes asur again on Shimon. Ba'aleha ida chasara ale dehai. No, you need Baalea. Rashi. Baalea hai. When Shimon marries the Kishinasa Haron Asara la Rishon. Baalea echad. Girsha sheni vechizira Rishon. Hare lecha isur kal belav. Right? The love of Machzik Rushato. The Asara la sheni was Osero on the second one. The Hadar hav yelegabe Girushato mishen iset. It's Girushato mishen iset even for the second guy. The second guy became asur, even though he's the oser. Right? The second guy is the oser her on Reuven. And now when Reuven did the isur of going with his wife again, he was oser on the oser. So we're saying like this. Let's go back and see also what we're saying. The Tanya, Ota Shchivata Osata Ven Shchivata Chota Osata. Shiach Velo Dinu. Uma B'makom Shebal Isur Kal. Machzik Grushato Mishenised. Ne'esar HaOser. When the first husband took her back, the second husband now became Asur on her. Makom Shebal Isur Hamur like a hot Isha. En Odin Shene'esar HaOser. Certainly, the Oser, which is the wife, should become Asur because you went with Azizda. Says Gemara, Male Machzi Girushato Mishenised, Sheken Tamahaguf, the Isura Berov, the Isura Isur Olam. Says, no, there's three differences over here. Machzi Girushato Mishenised, you were with the object of Isur, meaning you slept with the woman that's becoming Asur on him. So you were mitameh her. Mashenken, you want to make my wife, the guy's wife, Asur, when he slept with her sister? How could How could the tumah travel from the sister to the wife? It's not the same. It's much different if I'm metameh the item. I say the item is asur. I'm metameh something else, and this item becomes asur. Mahazik girushato mishinised. Rachel is the object. Reuven was with Rachel. Shimon was with Rachel. Reuven was with Rachel again. So when Reuven was with Rachel again, he was metameh her legabe Shimon. I put the tumah in the object of isur, right? Like when I take a mit and I touch a piece of terumah, the terumah became asur because I touched it. The lady became asur because I was boeler.
Right.
Very good. So Mashenken, in the case of Ahota, he's not touching his wife. He's being metameh her sister, and the tumah is going to sort of transfer over to.
It's not because of her. Not because of her.
It's not the same. You can't compare. You can't compare being metameh her to being metameh her. Maybe there's the big givamot. There's none over there. Not sure. Down. I don't know if this says Gemara. So that's one. Look in Rashi. Malam Mahazir. Tomar bebala hot ishto shete esor ishto shelonet magufa. That's one. The isura hot ishto. Eno isur olam. It's not a forever isur. Why? Because ahot ishto machzik grushato, once he's with her, it's over. She's asur on him forever. Ahot ishto, when the wife dies, she's muteret, so it's more kal. Shemeta ishto mutar bahoto. Rashi says isur berov lo garzim. Fine. Ela amaresh lakish yevama. It's yevama. Yevama leman. Who's yevama? Ilay mela aher. She marries somebody else. Uchd Rav Hamnuna, like Rav Hamnuna holds. The Amar Rav Hamnuna, Shomeret Yavam Shizinta. A lady whose husband died. Now she's waiting for the brother-in-law. And during the interim, she had Zinut. Asur Ali Vama, she's not allowed to go to her brother-in-law anymore. Let's see Rashi. Yavama Leman, Mi Ba'al Lehabi. So the Yavama is the Isur Kal, right? Who's the Osra? The Osra is the Yavam. He's causing her not to be able to marry anybody else, right? And she went and she had Zinut, Ne'esar Ha'oser. She went to the Asur, Ne'esar Ha'oser. Right?
The Yavam.
So too, by Ahot Ishto, if he went with the Asur, Ne'esar Ha'oser. You got it, Albert? Right? Rega. Says Gemara. Let's see Rashi. Ilay mi yivamah le'acher. Sheba aleha echad min ashuk. She's left with somebody outside the family. Ha'ini usur kal delav be'alma. It's a love of lo tiye ha'eshet ha'met ha'utza. The katani ne'esara oser ne'esar ba'yivamah. The brother-in-law is asur. Shaya osra alze. He was the cause of asur. Uchdrav hamnuna. Mali Yavama again. Shekenet Mahaguf. She's the object of the Isur, and she was defiled. The Isur Aberov. Rashi Lechol Adam, he be Isur. It applies to many people. Hachelo Halza, anybody that she didn't holetz to, anybody that she went with before the Halitza, she was Asur. Tomar ba Hotisha She'en Asura El Alaze. And she wasn't Itma. The Yivama to the other brothers. What's the case? Avad ba ma'amar. Right?
So
there's two brothers. One of them made ma'amar. He's the osir. He osir to with his ma'amar on the other brother.
Or anybody, not only brother, anybody. Yeah.
She was ready asur on everybody in the world, right, Jack? So there were only two people that were mutar in her, Reuven and Shimon, right? Reuven made ma'amar, he was osir on Shimon.
Right?
Avad ba ma'amar, hai, asara ale dehai. He made a asur on Shimon. Ba'ale ha'idach, now Shimon has bi'a with her. Asara ale dehai, he made a asur on Reuven. So to over here, by having bi'ah with the wife's sister, and the ne'esar, you said the cause of the isur. Says the Gemara, my iria the balei hasheni. You want to make a kavahomer to make the first one asur. You don't even need a bi'ah. אפילו עבד בנמי מאמר. If he made מאמר, he's אוסרה. So you're going to say that if somebody makes kiddushin to his wife, sister, his wife's asur? It's halokashia, no. Kerabban Gamliel. The bright is going like Rabban Gamliel. The amar en ma'amar ahar ma'amar. So ma'amar ahar ma'amar is not going to be osera. Ela, afilu natan la get. If he gave her a get, he's posel her on the first one. The afilu halatzla. So that doesn't work. Yivama doesn't work. So what's the isur kal? Ela amar b'yohanan. Sota is a case of Eshet Ish, Rashi. Shenivala leboel neesar ba'ala hausra alav. Right? An Eshet Ish who goes with the boel is osir a husband. Sota leman. Ilema leba'al. What do you mean? Sota ilay malibaal. You're gonna tell me your sota, she cheated, right? And if the husband goes with her, he's osera on the other guy. Ma'ir ya baaliha. Filu natan la get. Even if he divorces her, she can't go with the boel. Va'filu amar la amar any mashke. Sota is nistera. Really. She was alone with the guy. Rashi, sota leman, a sota lady that was alone with another man. Right, so the husband made kinui, and she went alone. So the going along with the guy, two witnesses saw her alone with him. Right,
saw her just alone.
Alone, right? Then she becomes asur on husband. But she's asur mi doraita, right? Ine melebaal shenivala lebaal ahar shekinala. You're gonna tell me she had bia with the husband after the kunui. Vinistera, and she was. He told her don't be alone with him, and she went alone with him. Da asirale, so she became asur on husband. Dichtiv vinistera, vinitma vekatani neesara oser asara al haboel. She's asur on the boel. Afilu la'ahar mitato. Or afilu kishigirsha. Right? She becomes asur even on the boel forever, even if the husband dies. So, ma'ir ya ba'aleha. Belo ba'aleha nami. Even if the husband never sleeps with her again. Misha'a shenistera imo. Ne'isra al ba'al. Ve'al boel le'olam. She becomes asur forever. Hashetishter. I'll tell you what the Gemara thought. Because if the husband's. She was alone with Shimon, let's say, right? Technically, if Reuven, her husband, takes it to the Beit HaMikdash, gives her a mesota, she becomes mutar to Reuven, to the husband, and to the other guy. If the husband divorces her, she's mutar to the other guy. Now, but if the husband sleeps with her, so now the mayim is not mashke, is not bodek. So at that point, she becomes asur forever. To everybody, to the husband and the boy. Yeah, because she's a sota that couldn't drink, right? So the Gemara, but what does she need? What does he need to be balea? Even if he gives her a get, or he says any mashke otach, it also doesn't work. It also it's not the bi'a, it's the lack of drinking. Va'afilo amar en any mashke, ela. The opposite case. Sota leboel. So sota leba'al is an isur kal. It's a lav. Right? V'nitme'ah. The husband's not allowed to be with her after she when they're waiting for the hashkab. That's an isur kal. It's a lav. So no, ela sota leboel. It's the opposite. When the sota slept with the other guy, she became asur on the husband. Says the Gemara, ela sota leboel. Hai isur kal hu? Eshet Ish is an Isur Kal?
Maybe after. After divorce her, maybe.
But it's the first Bia. The first Bia is when she's an Eshet Ish. It's not an Isur Kal. That's Homesh Hamurot. Right? Ha Isur Kalu, Isur Hamur. Dahainu Eshet Ish. How are you calling it Isur Kal? Says Gemara. Ela. Amarava Eshet Ish. It is Eshet Ish. וכן כי אתה רבין אמר רבי יוחנן אשת איש ועמי קרי לה איסור קל what's the matter with us? שאין האוסרה אוסרה כל ימיו because meaning אשת איש is חמור שבחמורות however there's a kula there for example compared to other עריות it's not forever it could be undone Give her a get. Give her a get. Masha'en came to other things. Mother-in-law never becomes mutar. Father's wife never becomes mutar. Imo never becomes mutar.
Even divorce.
Nothing, right. My kari le isur kal she'en osra osra kol yamav. He's not osir her his whole life. Masha'en ken ahot isha is chamur because the osir is osir at least her whole life.
What? Didn't he say before that if the isha dies, her mother's allowed?
That was Rabbi Yehuda. But, I'm sorry, Rabbi Akiva, and maybe not allowed, just not hayav mita. Well, if the husband, until the husband dies, yeah. She's asur kol yamav, or until it gets, so it's not kol yamav.
A regular case, not sotah.
No matter, an eshet ish.
Somebody
won't
eshet ish.
She's asur forever.
Forever, that's what I said. Even if you do,
but eshet ish herself is considered isur kal because it could come off in the lifetime of the person that made her asur. Masha'en ken ahot isha, as long as the wife who caused the sister to be asur, had the wife caused to be asur by taking kiddushin, the sister's asur her whole life. So the sister is more hamur than eshet ish. Tanya nami achi. Abba Hanan Amar Mishum Rabbi Lazar Eshet Ish Uma Bimkom HaBaal Isur Kal. If somebody goes with the Eshet Ish She'ena Osra Osra Kol Yamav, who the one who made her Asur, the sister doesn't osir, the husband who made her Asur doesn't Osir his whole life because he can give again. Ne'esar HaOsir, the husband becomes Asur in her. HaBaal Isur Hamur, if somebody sleeps with an Isur Hamur Ahot Isha. Why is Ahot Isha Hamur? Sha'osra osra kol yama, because the sister makes her asur as long as she's alive. En odin she'ne'esar ha'osra, certainly the osra, which is the sister, should become asur. Tamud lomar ota shechivata osarta, the shechiva of an eshet ish is osir. Then shechivat achota osarta, and the shechiva of a sister is not osir. Why the Gemara didn't say?
You want to cook cold, you don't need
nitzah. I don't know. Same question. That's what I said. Rabbi Yossi Omer, kol sheposel. Okay, more Chinese. Rabbi Yossi Omer, back in the Mishnah, kol sheposel al yedei acherim, posel al yedei atzmo. Whoever is posel for others is posel to himself. The kol sheem posel al yedei acherim, whoever is not posel for others is not posel for himself. Rashi says, "Bigmara mefarish." Now the time has come. Maika Amar, what's he talking about? Maika Amar Rabbi Yossi, what's Rabbi Yossi saying? Ilema, do you want to tell me the Ka'amar Tanakama? Tanakama said, "The azil ishto v'gisol medinat hayam." The wife went with her sister's husband to medinat hayam. Have we said that yesterday? The azil ishto v'gisol medinat hayam. And they said they both died, and her husband married her sister, who was her brother-in-law's wife. So it's not. He married her sister, who was also married. So it's not the heter that they got based on the edim was not only, the guy's wife is dead, so you can marry her sister. It's also the sister-in-law's husband is dead, so she's allowed to get married. There were two heterim there, right? And generally, based on the rules that we had, a woman who gets married on evidence that her husband dies and then is proven wrong, she becomes asur on both husbands. Whereas when a husband marries his wife's sister on evidence that his wife died, doesn't become asur on the sister-in-law or his wife. So now, what happens when you put the two together? Right, Maika Amar Rabbi Yossi. Ilema de ka'amar tana kama da azil ishto v'giso lemdinat hayam. Eshet giso asira. His sister-in-law is asur on her husband and on him. The ishto sharia, but his wife stays muteret. Why not? What? Show up. That's not something that makes you asur. Didn't we just say ota? Right? The ishto sharia. The Ka'amar le Rabbi Yossi says no. Ki hechi the ishto sharia, just like his wife is mutar. Eshet giso nami sharia, we're going to be matir the sister-in-law to her husband also.
Rashi learned over here that the Adam is not a problem.
So then it's the wrong, it's phrased the wrong way. Ihachi, why does it say?
She's a problem.
It says kol sheposel, posel. It should say, if your main cause is to say that what you say is asur, I say is mutar, you should have said kol she'em pasul first. Kol she'i achi, kol she'em posel al yedei achirim, em posel al yedei atzmo. Whoever is not posel others, meaning, since my wife is not asur on me, so the sister-in-law is not asur on husband. Kol she'em posel. Sorry, that's it. Why does it say kol she'em posel ayedei achirim? Whoever is not posel others, is not posel himself. It should say kol she'em posel ayedei atzmo, eno posel ayedei achirim. Since he's not asur in his wife, his sister is not asur on her husband. Mi ba'ele. Ve'ela. So let's say he's saying the opposite. Ki hechi the eshet giso asira. Just like the sister-in-law is asur. Ishto nami asira. His wife becomes asur on him. It's not fair that she becomes asur and his wife is mutar. Ha-teinach. I understand the first part. Kol she-posel al yedei atzmo, posel al yedei achirim. Oh, sorry. Kol she-posel al yedei achirim, posel al yedei atzmo. Since you were osir, the sister-in-law, your wife becomes asur on you. Look at Rashi. Elaki echi de eshet giso asura ishto nami asira ho'il ve'ahani hani nisuin. Since your marriage to your sister-in-law helped leposla al ba'ala to make her asura on her husband, ahanu nami, it helps liyot chashuva ki ishto, that she, the sister-in-law, is considered your wife. Le'soret ahota alav, therefore you can't marry her sister. Mishum ahotisha midrabanan. That's fine. But what's my kol she'em posel, em posel? What's that teaching me? Kol she'em posel al yedeat, sorry. Hatenach kol she'em posel, kol she'en posel mayavete. What's that coming to teach? Amar Rabbi Ami. Areisha. It's going on the Reisha. Rashi, hi kol she'en posel. The first part is like we said. Just like the sister-in-law is asur on her husband, his wife is asur on him. But this one is going on the reisha. Hi, look at Rashi. Hi, kol she'en posel areisha kai. The Airi was talking b'she'en posel al yedei achirim. The Airi le'el b'niset al pi edim. Right? We had Rabbi Shimon saying that when she got married based on edim, she's not asur on her husband. It's considered an onus, and she could go back. I called. She goes back to husband. The katani seifa, the harkach bat ishto. We have the case of if his wife came back, muteret lahazor lo. Lo shna al pi edim. Doesn't make a difference if there's witnesses. Sha'amru lo meta ishtecha, ula hot ishto amru met ba'ali. The eshet giso sharia lahazor le ba'ala. Lo shna al pi edecha, the eshet giso asura ishto sharia. Right? The Tanakhama holds, even in a case where one Eid came, and when the case of one Eid, the sister-in-law becomes Asur, his wife will be Mutar. Because the Tanakhama doesn't go Zed on a wife because he was with her sister. Rabbi Yossi, who does, says, let's see it inside the Gemara. Amar Rab Ami Areisha. When it says, Niset al pi bedin, Tetze upetura min korban al pi edim tetze vechayev be korban yafe kocho shel bedin shepotra min korban. But we said when she niset al pi edim, she goes back to her husband. Vekamar tana kamalosh na al pi edim the eshet giso shari. It doesn't make a difference if the heter of the reason why you married your sister was because edim came and said that they both died. Where in that case, the Eshet Giso Sharia, when they both come back, the sister-in-law goes back to her husband because she was an ones, right? V'losh na'al pi betin, or if they got married based on one Eid, the Eshet Giso Asira. We don't hold like that, but Rabbi Shimon held like that. The Eshet Giso Asira,
Right? Or it came back, al pi betin and one ed, that the sister-in-law is asur to her husband. Even so, his wife is mutar. Ve'ka'ama le Rabbi Yossi, Rabbi Yossi tells the Tanakama, al pi betin de posel al yedei acherim, by betin, that other people are posel. Meaning, the sister-in-law can't go back to her husband. Posel al yedei atzmo. So to, since the sister-in-law, since marrying your sister-in-law made her like your wife to be asur on her husband, so too, your wife is now your sketch wife sister and can marry you. Posel yedei atzmo. But al pi edim, when you married your sister-in-law, because two edim said that your brother-in-law died and your wife died, the eno posel al yedei achirim, that he's not posel others, because since it's al pi edim, the sister-in-law could go back to her husband because it's an honest. Eno posel al yedei atzmo. Over there, I say that he could still go back to his wife because we didn't consider the marriage anything because we let his sister-in-law go back. Rashi. When the sister-in-law married you, one ed, I argue. I say, just like she's a suit husband, your wife is a suit to you.
If the guy marries the sister, and he doesn't want to go back to his wife.
No. There's no choice. There's no choice because the sister-in-law's wife, husband came back.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Yeah, but we hold that.
One second. He married his wife. His sister-in-law married somebody else, right? Somebody said that the only way he could marry that sister-in-law is only if her husband died and his wife dies. Yeah. Right? They didn't die. There's nothing to do. Sorry, no backsies.
I didn't know they didn't want to know. You guys went so far ahead.
I'm not here. I don't
know what right. Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha Amar Le'olam HaSeifa. Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha says it's really going on the Seifa. The whole thing on the Seifa. So how do I have Eno Posel? Hi, the Azli Arusato Vegiso. Ha the Azli Ishto Vegiso. Depends who left. Depends what your situation was. He changes it a little bit. He says, Ha Kol She Posel Al Yedei Acherim. Posel Yedei Atzmo is talking when his wife that went wasn't married to him. She was engaged to him. So when she left and he married the sister-in-law, right? They say they could think that how did he marry the sister-in-law? Because there was a Tanai in the Erusin. So even though his wife came back, his marriage to the sister-in-law could be legal. The brother-in-law could have divorced the sister-in-law, and the wife was a Tanai in the Kiddushin. So therefore, the sister-in-law can't go back to the brother-in-law because she needs a gift from you because maybe she was divorced, and your wife, your Arusa, you can't marry her because maybe there was a Tanai, and your first one of the sisters that you wound up married to was the one that you married after they told you the Arusa left. Right? Had the Azli Arusato. Vigiso, had asli ishto vigiso. The kamar tanakam is not mehalik. Loshna ishto vigiso, loshna rusato vigiso. Eshet giso asira. The sister-in-law is asur. The ishto sharia. And your wife is muteret. Regular rules. The kamar let Rabbi Yossi. Ishto vigiso, the wife and the sister-in-law. The lekele memer tena'a hava lebenisuin. There's no way to say that you married. That you married your sister-in-law, if your wife is alive, because you can't say that we're not going to assume there was a tanai in a consummated marriage. The eno posel al yedei acher, eno posel al yedei atzmo. So you're not going to be posel the acher because nobody could assume that you were actually married to your sister-in-law. So eno posel al yedei atzmo, he's not posel himself. Arusato v'giso. But when his wife is only engaged to him, it's possible that he gave kiddushin to his arusa, told the almanat something or other, she went away because it didn't work, and then he married the sister-in-law's husband died, legally, Right? Now the brother-in-law comes back. We have to make him give a get. Memela, she can't marry the brother-in-law. Memela, your wife is asur on you. Right? Tanava le bekidushin uposela yedei achirim posela yedei atzmo. Amar of Yehuda Amar. Shmuel halacha ker biyosi. That what? That by arusato. By arusato. She's asur and the sister-in-law is asur on her husband. By ishto, they're both mutar. Says the Gemara, Matkif la Rabbi Yosef, Rav Yosef, Umiyama Shmuel, Hachi, Vaha Itmar, we learned, Yivama, a sister-in-law, Rav Amar, Harehu Ke'eshet Ish, Vishmuel Amar, Eno Ke'eshet Ish. What's the Mahlok? Amar Vuna, Kegon Shekidesh Ahiv Et Ha'isha. His brother married a woman, Vahalach Lom Nidayatayam. He went away. He heard that his brother died. He made yibum to the wife. The Rav Amar, Rav says, Harehi ke'eshet ish v'asura liyabam. She's like an eshet ish and she can't go back to her husband. No, so over here the case is like this. Yiva eshet yivama meaning an arusa. Kegon shekidesh achiv et aisha. He didn't marry her, he only made kiddushin. V'alach lo l'medinat hayam. V'shama shemet achiv v'amad v'nasa et ishto. The Rav Amar eo keshet ish. She has a case of regulation ish. Why? Even though when the brother comes back, nobody could say that the brother divorced her and you married her.
Did you move or did what?
He thought he did yibum. Yeah? Very nice. But the brother's here, so it's not yibum. Right? When Reuven went away. He married a woman, he went away. They heard that Reuven died, Shimon, Tzadik, he made yibum. Yeah? Now Reuven comes back. What are people going to say happened? Reuven divorced her, Shimon married her? That doesn't work, right? Al-Kochach, they have to know what happened. They thought he died. They're forced to come to the right conclusion. They must have thought Reuven died, and Shimon married her by mistake. So there's no reason to say she can't go back to Reuven. No, because they know it was a mistake. No, but it's impossible, as long as Reuven is alive, it's impossible for Shimon to legally marry his wife, right? Good. So in a case where there was Nisuin, there's no reason to say that the wife can't go back to Reuven, because everybody knows it was a mistake. If it was a Kiddushin, right? If it was Erusin, so they might say, oh, you know how Shimon married her? Reuven never really, the marriage didn't work. He said, I'll marry you on condition that you agree to come with me on vacation. She said, no. And the Kiddushin was off, so Shimon said, hey man, if you don't want her, I'll take her. Right. So even though Reuven comes and he's standing here, people will say, yeah, Shimon married her.
No problem.
Shimon married her. Now she's going back to Reuven. Haram? They're not going to say, therefore she becomes a suit. So when does Rav say, Yivama hareo ke'eshet ish, whose husband went away? Kegon shekidesh achiv et aisha v'alach lo l'medinat hayam v'shama shemet achiv v'amad v'nasa et ishto t'rav amar eo keshet ish v'asura li yabam v'shmuel amar ena keshet ish v'shar yale. So you see, Shmuel says even in the case of an engagement, he doesn't hoshesh maybe there was a tanai in the kiddushin, and by a brother who married the brother's wife from Erusin, he doesn't hoshesh. So how come over here is Choshesh for Biyosi, who says that it's what's it called? That if they were engaged, if the brother-in-law was engaged to the sister-in-law and he married her, where so because we're Choshesh for tonight, it's Lechaura, brother's wife or wife's sister is the same. Meaning it's the same problem. You're saying that maybe the Erusim was all tonight. Amar le Abaye, umimai dechi amar Shmuel alacha k'Rabbi Yosi ad Rabbi Yitzchak nafcha k'amar. Who says that when Shmuel said alacha is like Rabbi Yosi, he was going on the second way of explaining it, that it's talking about Erusin? Dilma ad Rabbi Ami k'amar. Maybe he's going on Rabbi Ami, who said that the difference between,
that it's discussing only the reisha. Al pi edim, al pi betin. V'inami ad Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha, and even if you're talking about Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha, who said that it's arusa, that it's talking about arusa and not arusa, mimai de'aposel, v'dilma eno posel. Maybe he's only coming to say that halacha is like Rabbi Yossi, that when she's fully married, there's no isur of the sister-in-law because it's impossible to become asur. He's not coming to talk about the arusa that it is. He's posek like Rabbi Yossi only for half, only for the fact that if it was nisuin, there's for sure no isur because it's impossible. Inami, mimai di'ita l'drav huna. Maybe we disagree with Rav Huna's way. Dilma leke l'drav huna klal. Maybe we're not talking about Rav Huna. Rav Hamnuna kamiflagi. They're arguing about Rav Hamnuna. The Amar Rav Hamnuna shomeret yavam shizinta asura livama. Right, when he said yavama hareke eshet ish, he's talking about a regular simple case. A yavama hetzinut. Right, Rav says she's like an eshet ish. Rav says she's like an eshet ish, and she can't go to the yavam. She became asur. Right, the Amar of Hamnuna Shmuel was in the Asur Ali Vama. Rama Harei Keshet Ish, Umifsel Abizmum. So, any Keshet, Lo Mifsel Abiznut. So, there's a lot of different ways to do it. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. Be'ezat Hashem. Baruch Hashem.